camp counselors of Reddit. What is the most NSFW thing you've seen happen at camp? I was a camp counselor a few years ago at a camp for foster kids. One week a counselor caught a camper, M15, in bed with another camper, F14. The room they were in was tiny. And the four other girls in the bunks were awake and cheering them on. They were loud enough to wake the counselor, who pulled the male camper out of bed. The guy had a Ziploc bag around his dick, held in place by a rubber band. I was both impressed at their dedication to trying to have safe sex, and appalled at how terribly they went about it. My favorite one was a 13-year-old boy at camp out. Both his hands were in his sleeping bag and he was clearly masturbating. His counselor called a hand check where you have to display both hands in the air. He only raised one hand. The counselor asked for both hands and he replied, "Give me 4 minutes. Saw a girl give a guy a hand job under a towel. On the bus. On the bus filled with children. On the bus filled with children going to a Christian camp. Counselors having a threesome in an empty cabin next to the bathrooms. Finally a chance to post this. One year I was working a regular camp and had a lead counselor run over to another counselor and I to say, look in the first stall of the boys' bathroom. We left our kids with our age group's female counselors and ran. By the time we made it, a crowd of counselors had formed around the toilet. Contained inside was by far the mightiest, largest turd I have ever seen in my life. Easily a diameter of 3 inches and long enough to be far down into the toilet while also free-willying out of the surface of the water. No campers were told about this. A few days later a camper asked me if we were running to the bathroom the other day because of a giant piece of poop and claimed to be the conjurer of it. I was mortified. I was working at a Young Life camp in Colorado probably 12 years ago. I think it was the first day right around dinner time and a girl just up and died. Her heart just stopped. She was sitting talking with her friends and fell over. It was incredibly intense and very sad for a lot of people and tons of people were there to witness it. It's not the most scandalous of camp stories, but it was certainly pretty ducked up and put a weird vibe on the rest of the week. I was a counselor at a day camp. We took kids to the zoo. A kid shoved his thumb fully inside a petting zoo goat's butt. I asked him why and he just shrugged, looking at me like I'm the idiot. I felt bad for the goat but it was still standing next to him. So maybe it was into it. We heard rumors about the cabin next to us one week at camp. It was a game called Monkey and it involved one of the kids getting naked and putting a sock over his dick. He'd then swing around the room using the bed frames and whatnot, making monkey noises. To this day I'm not sure what the game was. I'm guessing you won if you didn't get raped. I had 2 twin brothers that were very handsy with each other. One day one of them came to me crying because his brother had bit his tongue after he tried kissing him. I was a day camp counselor during the summers in high school. I watched another counselor eat herself out after smoking by the gully. My 16-year-old self couldn't look away. Also, generally, the counselors are ducking like rabbits. There was this Asian kid named Kevin who went to the bathroom to take a rit. But there was pee on the toilet seat so he started to cry and then took a rit on the floor because he really had to go. I was a camp counselor years ago and while I don't recall really seeing anything NSFW with the kids, I can tell you almost everything I saw with the counselors was NSFW. I couldn't walk into a room without seeing people ducking. Intense. On top of the staff washing machines. In the general store. Parents. If you send your kids to camp, just remember, literally the only thing those counselors are thinking about is ducking each other. I worked at a sleepaway Girl Scout camp with all female counselors and staff where a solid 60% were lesbian. There was a strictly enforced no more ducking in the bushes rule, because so many counselors would go at it anywhere they could find. Saw a 13-year-old ducking a 12-year-old. And the position they were in. How did they learn that ? Edit, and the position was, menshealth.com. Considering this is the position I believe is most likely to cause pregnancy and all due to gravity. I have no idea how or why this was the position they chose or how they knew about it. I work in a building that hosts a camp for people with autism and other mental handicaps. A guy with something was really attached to his counselor. A girl. He really liked her and asked her out almost every hour of the week. She finally said, "No, I have a boyfriend," or something along those lines. He got really mad and stripped down. And freaked out. He peed and pooped all over the floor. When other counselors were trying to calm him down, he ran over to a fire extinguisher box and smashed his head into the glass. He had big chunks of glass in his face and forehead. Bleeding everywhere. We were told as building managers to stay clear of the floor he was on. They would clean it all up. It was odd. Another story, when he left the building we also found a sort of poop shrine. He would poop in the closet and then mold underwear to it. He must have used a whole can of Febreze on the thing a day because we never knew about it. Couldn't smell anything. Ex-counselor here. Our camp has a thing where one night all the people who had been there for 3 years go out and do crazy it in the fields by the camp. Needless to say, I saw a lot of breasts. But other than that and smoking weed, nothing really big happened. Apparently in years before, some of the abandoned cabins were used during that night for rowdy sex parties with lots of alcohol involved. This was back in like the 1990s, where I guess the upper staff were a lot more lenient. I worked at the camp in 2010, so I guess I missed the really interesting stuff. It was interesting to bring up the topic to my boss, who worked at the camp as a counselor at that time, and see him get all red-faced and not know what I was talking about. TLDR. A wild night once a year used a crazy sex party, but not we just flash each other and smoke. Day 1 at camp. We jumped out of the bus and ran around because we were so excited. My friend ran behind the bus and the bus ran him over. He was rushed off by ambulance. We didn't see him for another 3 months. Edit spelling. I sound like a 12-year-old in those few sentences. I'm 42. Was checking rooms after everyone was supposed to have moved out. Found a 12-year-old ducking another 12-year-old male and coming just as I opened the door. They didn't hear me, so I waited a few minutes, then knocked on the door and opened it to find two innocent kids packing their bags. They apologized for being slow to get out of their room.